Hi, my name is Matt Chenoweth, MDOT Detroit TSC Development Engineer. I was the project manager for the big M39 reconstruct that is already underway. Behind me, as part of this project, is the Pembroke Road Bridge over M39. The scope of work on this bridge is a superstructure replacement. And we're using innovative materials on this bridge. We're going to be using a 40 millimeter carbon fiber composite cable for our transverse post tensioning as opposed to steel. We're also going to be using a carbon fiber grid reinforcement in the deck as opposed to steel rebar. Another innovative material we're using on this bridge is the extruded polystyrene blocks as backfill behind the abutments. If we didn't do that, the fill behind the abutments overstressed the abutments, which would cause us to have to replace them. By using the extruded polystyrene blocks, it increases our construction time is decreased because we don't have to replace the abutments. The original lights that you see right here are just our high pressure sodium Cobra head lights, and we're going to be replacing them with LED lights. As part of the development of this bridge and using the carbon fiber materials, we worked in close collaboration with Dr. Nabil Grace from Lawrence Technological University, and we are going to head over to the Detroit Maintenance Garage with Dr. Grace right now to inspect the materials that have been delivered to the garage. The three containers you see here that are protected by the barrier are the carbon fiber cables that we will be putting in the Pembroke structure. Typically at MDOT we use steel transverse post tensioning strands. For the Pembroke Bridge, we're using 12 carbon fiber composite cables. This is a sample of what the carbon fiber cable looks like. This is the anchorage, which will be outside of the beam. We stress from this end. There's a big nut that goes on here, and then we transfer the stresses into the beam. Here you can see the 37 individual cables that make up the one giant cable. So in each of these boxes, we have four cables that are 67 feet, 3 inches long, and they're spooled around a big spool. On the side of each box, you can see the unpacking instructions for the cable, which it's very important. The cable can't be kinked, or it can't be nicked, or any sort of mechanical abrasion. It'll damage the cable. So MDOT's already met with CA Hull, the contractor. We brought them out here, and when we get to the erection of the bridge, they're actually going to have a plan as to how they're going to unwind these, how they're going to keep them straight, and how they're going to install them into the bridge.
Well, this is a material for the future. It should be very much sustainable, and also it's, if you look from corrosion point of view, this material is not going to corrode like steel. It can last twice the lifespan of a steel conventional materials.
At the Detroit Maintenance Garage, we also inspected the grid reinforcement, the carbon fiber grid reinforcement that's going to go into the bridge deck on this. Dr. Grace will be with us out on site during construction. We're also going to be wiring up the bridge with strain gauges to monitor the long-term performance of the bridge, and we're looking forward to a great project.